This is my current computer desk. In this video, I'd like to try and make a new computer desk, which is a lot bigger and less cluttered. I want it to span from here to the wall, which is about 2.5 meters, and I want to basically eliminate these two pieces of furniture and have one. So above the desk is going to be a shelving system similar to this. I'll show you a diagram. The frame of the desk is going to be made up from 40 by 40 steel extrusions, and that'll all be welded together with a timber top, which I plan on experimenting with some parquetry style joinery from recycled timber. The shelves will be supported by galvanized pipes and fittings, and under the shelves are going to be LED strip lights to give me lighting. I'm hoping to put in a storage compartment for my computer, like on this desk, and maybe a drawer or a little shelf there. I'm not sure if I'll do two shelves or one, but we'll see how we go. Okay, here we go. So I'm using 40mm by 40mm square galvanized steel for this desk, for the majority of it. For some pieces I'll be using a thinner square section. My angle grinder isn't big enough to cut through the tube in one go, so here I'm marking out a line around the exterior so that I can cut straight. That never lines up. Galvanized steel produces a poisonous gas, zinc oxide, because it's been galvanized in zinc, so that's why I'm wearing a mask. I don't know why I'm justifying myself. If I want to wear a mask, I'll wear a mask. Who do you think you are, telling me not to wear a mask? Jeez. So you can see down there on the right, those are all my pieces, steel pieces that I'll need for the desk. I'm now putting them together and I'm about to weld. So I'm using those 90 degree magnets, which I actually criticized in the past in a previous video, but I'm starting to like them and appreciate them, so I take that back. Now I'm dividing the length of the desk into thirds so that I can make space for the timber panels which I'll be making. Because I'm using an arc welder, it produces slag around the weld, so I'm just chipping that off with a hammer. Hot damn, look at those welds! I know you're sitting there with weld envy. Using my new 18 volt Makita brushless angle grinder to clean up those welds. So nice having cordless tools. So here I'm putting the leg supports on, and I'm just holding them with magnets, and I've welded them off camera. And now I'm putting the table top on. It's a little bit off because I was actually welding on uneven concrete, and it kind of threw everything out. So what I'm doing here is using a clamp to just to align the legs. And there it is, all welded up. Local resident.
Have a look at this. What a beauty. It's a stumpy thing, lizard. I said it first.
Now I'm making a little cupboard for my computer. So this is a smaller piece of steel. This is, I think, 20mm by 20mm. Didn't need to be as heavy gauge, so I'm using that thinner one.
Ooh, hello. Glad to be here. That's a keeper. Yes, put it in the skin box, please. Fishy Irish. I'm peeling.
Oh, that's just disgusting.
Yeah, I got a little sunburnt. bit of a pain filming this because you set up the piece of steel and then you have to run off and set the camera up away from the welder because I don't want to damage the camera retina, so, or processor or whatever it is. Okay, so now I'm cutting timber panels, which are going to go inside the desktop. So those third sections that you saw, each of those is going to have one of these pieces. And these are just plywood because I'm using them as a support for the parquetry tops. So I just needed something that I could glue and nail the nice timber to. So I've got three pieces there, one for each section. Just checking that they fit. Okay, so for the cupboard door on my new desk, I'm salvaging these old hinges off the old desk. Now, nothing fancy, it's just a little metal pin that sticks up from the top and down from the bottom. So I'll just have to drill two holes and then I can secure it. For the cupboard handle, I'm trying to go with like an industrial style, so I'm using this, what is it, a valve knob. Let's call it a valve knob. And I'm drilling a hole for the valve handle and just tightening that onto the door. I lost the footage of me installing the door, so you won't see that happen.
What is this for?
Yeah, you're going to have you build me a bed without...
Are you serious?
Fucking paying for it, what are you talking about?
You buy me lunch.
That's not enough, man.
You legend.
Engine engineer Tyler. I helped him make a bed a few weeks ago. Not make a bed as in with linen and everything, but I physically helped him build a bed. And so he came over for the day, gave me a hand, and brought me a case of cider. What a legend. Now we're painting the frame of the desk. And I'm using this wire mesh now to make a cable tray that'll go underneath the desk and hide all the cables. Because cables are a pain in the butt, no one likes cables. So I'm using the vise now as kind of just a lever. It's a bit tricky because I had to bend it over onto itself, but you just make lots of little adjustments and you can work it into the shape that you want. The cable tray is hidden anyway, so it doesn't need to be perfect, and it beats having cables hanging down, so. That'll do. Quick coat of paint just to hide the rust. And now screwing it on with some self-tapping screws. Now clearing out the old desk. I really hate that desk. It's just so small and cramped. And here we go, the final moment of truth. I've had so many different people tell me that this desk wasn't going to fit into my room, so I just wanted to show you all this.
Twist it.
Yeah.
Then we're going to go underneath. Well, actually, we'll come here and we'll twist it that way.
Yeah. Well, evidently not good.
We know.
We're not going to be able to spin this, dude.
No.
Try. You're gonna have to stand in there. Here we go. Good on my end. No.
Fuck.
Alrighty then. We'll just leave it here.
No.
You have no idea how frustrating this is. You spend weeks coming up with plans and drawing schematics, taking measurements. The one measurement I didn't take was the width of my door to my bedroom. Can't even fit the bloody thing in. Oh, I don't leave my house without this anymore. It's just so frustrating. On the other hand, I did get it in, and you're about to see how I did it. At least Dad was supportive. Okay, so I'm about to attempt to make the table disassemblable so that I can fit it into my room. The plan is to cut all the connections to the tabletop and then using smaller size tubing, create inserts that can slot the table together. Also be cutting it in half at the base, and then having an inner sleeve, which will mean that the table can be disassembled into three pieces. So I should be able to fit it into most spaces now. I purposely left a little bit of the existing legs, leg steel, so that I could use it as a guide to weld up these ones. So they are perfectly positioned, I just slot them in there and weld it, and then I can cut a length and leave the length of it exposed.
Die! do what you tell me. Fuck you, I won't do what you tell me. Fuck you, I won't do what you tell me. Fuck you, I won't do what you tell me. Fuck you, I won't do what you tell me. Fuck you, I won't do what you tell me. Fuck you, I won't do what you tell me. Fuck you, I won't do what you tell me. Fuck you, I won't do what you tell me. Fuck you, I won't do what you tell me. Fuck you, I won't do what you tell me. Fuck you, I won't do what you tell me. Fuck you, I won't do what you tell me. Motherfucker!
Quickly, quickly, thank you. Shave me from my shelf.
You're insane, gold member!
And that's the way, I like it. Keshi and the Sunshine Band.